Greetings. Thank you, Brother Zahur, for your prolific list of incorrect understanding. I believe you think you are sincere, brother, but you do not even consider what you write. In fact, your tone is argumentative and hostile, which is the fruit of Mohammed's religion. But I will gladly answer and explain the correct understanding to you, and let God deal with your heart. You must decide whether God's truth means anything to you, brother. He shall not cry. Why do you forget to quote his cry to God in the so-called alleged crucifixion of God, where he said, my Lord, why you have forsaken me? Well, let's look at what was actually written, brother, not what you incorrectly recall. Isaiah 42:2, he will not cry out or shout or make his voice heard in the streets. Prophet Isaiah is very clear, brother. Isaiah said Messiah would not cry out in the streets. Isaiah did not say Messiah would not cry out from the cross of crucifixion and suffering. I find, brother, that those who commit to Mohammed are careless when it comes to facts, accuracy, and the truth. This is not their choice, but the fruit of Mohammed's religion, brother. The so-called alleged crucifixion. The lies of Satan, brother, curse the message of the prophets. But an honest and sincere man will respect the prophets. The prophets foretold what Messiah would suffer. And Jesus Christ, the Messiah himself, the Son of God, confirmed their message. Then he said unto them, O fools and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Pay attention, brother. Jesus said to not believe the prophets is to be a fool and slow of heart. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? The International Standard Version, the Messiah had to suffer these things and then enter into his glory, didn't he? The New Living Translation, wasn't it clearly predicted that the Messiah would have to suffer all these things before entering his glory? Jesus said to not believe the prophets is to be a fool and slow of heart. Brother, you have believed lies told by Islam in the name of Muhammad. To steal the message of the prophets of Almighty God from you. Prophet David described the crucifixion of Messiah. Psalms 22:16, for dogs have surrounded me. A band of evildoers has encompassed me. They pierced my hands and feet. Prophet Zechariah confirmed Yahweh would be pierced. Zechariah 12:10, I will pour out on the house of David and on the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and of supplication, so that they will look on me whom they have pierced. Prophet David described his treatment on the cross. Psalm 69:21, they put gall in my food and gave me vinegar for my thirst. Matthew 27:48, immediately one of them ran and got a sponge. He filled it with wine vinegar, put it on a staff, and offered it to Jesus to drink. Brother, there are many more details the prophets revealed of the Messiah's life and death. If only you had respect for God and his prophets. I believe you think you are sincere, brother. In your heart, you may want to be on a true path to God. But Islam is a false path, brother. The proof is your rejection of the message of the prophets. You have been tricked to believe Muhammad's fables and lies. You wrote, both prophets of God, I have to stop you there, brother, because Mohammed was not a prophet of the God of Abraham. Mohammed is a false prophet. The proof is that Mohammed leads you to reject the message of the real prophets. Of this, there can be no doubt. The message, in fact, to compare a prophet who was patient for 23 years of hard suffering to a prophet of 3 years in mission, which was incomplete, is nonsense. Again, your rejection of the prophets and their message cripples you, brother. The Son of God accomplished what he was sent to do. The Son of God redeemed mankind from our sins, brother, just as the prophets of God said he would. So if you have any respect for God, my friend, you need to read and learn what the prophets revealed. Mohammed's religion spits on their message. But if you sincerely want to learn of the one true God, you must be willing to listen and think and learn. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.